Welcome, what is up? Thank you for tuning back into the Chaos Lair. Of course, I'm Chris Chaos here with your Raw 411 for April the 17th, 2017. Well, that was something, wasn't it? Of course we've all seen this happen before. They broke the fucking ring. Okay, they broke the fucking ring. We've seen it. Who did it better? Was it Lesnar and Big Show? Or was it Braun and Big Show? I want to think that the Lesnar one was better just because it was kind of more unexpected. This time they teased it way too much, and I had been noticing all night, why are the LED boards and the LED not around the post? And I kept thinking, there's got to be something going on. And then when they teased it the first time, I knew that's what's going. I knew they had to break the ring. I just knew it. But anyway, I also want to say, because I don't have it wrote down on my notes and I just remembered it, the Bray segment, I don't get it. I just don't. There is no other person on the WWE roster that frustrates me, and it's not their fault, it's creative's fault. And maybe it's Vince's fault. You know, maybe blame should start with him, because he is the end-all be-all of everything that we see on TV. So I want to blame Vince here. So frustrated. I just can't deal with it. Anyway, we start off the show, recap of last week with the big thing. The package, they took the crowd out of it, which was smart. But it's not like we don't know what happened. And we don't know, that we don't remember. It's not like we don't remember how the crowd reacted. And they ate it up. Braun comes out. Kurt comes out. Tells Braun to leave. Braun, no. Give me some competition, or else. Kurt's like, or else what? And later on, we find out, or else what? Samoa Joe versus Chris Jericho was, you know, it's a good match. Samoa Joe goes over. Back and forth promo with Rollins and Joe, which I really like Rollins on commentary. I like Rollins not working tonight. Now, he was in his gear. I assume, and we all know what happens when people assume, except for when I do it, I assume that he had a dark match main event. I don't know this as of this filming, or I would state it. I guess I could have looked it up. Raw's been over for over an hour. Of course, I've been watching my Grizzlies lose again. They got so close. Anyway, that's a whole nother story for a whole nother day. The Drifter backstage, just random. Love it. I love it. They're doing good by the Drifter. So far, after 2 weeks, so far, I am a big fan of it. Braun comes and kills Goldie and Truth. Good. I didn't want to see them wrestle anyway. Not that I'm hating on Goldie so much. I don't like Truth. I'm done. Let's get it done. The Club beats Enzo and Cass. Thank God. I'm at a point now where I'm starting to get like other people, and this Enzo doesn't need the mic every week. It's too much. It's oversaturation, and it's done. It needs to stop. Not every week. You know, maybe once every third week. At this point, because he's had the mic in his hand every Raw that he's been on, and he doesn't need it. He's over. We know he's over. He doesn't need it. So, why force feed us this, every week? Miz TV with Dean Ambrose. It goes about like you think it's going to. It ends up in a brawl. It wasn't really a brawl, but it was kind of a skirmish. And Miz powders. Braun is then shown kidnapping Kalisto, which is just funny. And then he says, ah, screw it. And he throws him in the garbage. And then Big Show pounces him out of nowhere. Old school TNA fans will remember. He just pounced him right out of nowhere into the Big Show did into the into the garage, the up door, whatever. It was just funny. And then tells Braun, pick on someone your own size, which is just funny. Gallagher and Perkins, they had a really good match. A lot of shenanigans going on. Austin Aries and Neville both outside the ring for this. And it just is what it is. Perkins wins. Hardy's backstage with Sheamus and Cesaro. It's funny. I heard, of course, everybody knows that I'm a big Taz show supporter. So I watch, and I try to watch his on-demand show every day. But he talked about how Matt is broken, but Jeff is not Brother Nero. And I kind of I disagreed with it when I heard him say it this morning, and I disagreed with it when he said it last week. He's using words like tremendous, and you know he used tremendous tonight, but he didn't say tremendous. He just said it's tremendous. He put a little twang on it, but that was the only, everything else. It was just Matt Hardy. It wasn't Broken Hardy that he was Broken Matt that he was how he was portraying in the interview. Finn Balor, but I'm skipping ahead. Sasha, Nia, Alexa Bliss, and Mickie James. Look, I said this on Twitter. I understand why it was these four. You have to put over the new talent that just come over to Raw, being Alexa Bliss and Mickie James. So you have to incorporate them in. You have to, you know, I mean, and that's fine. I also see why you want to put Nia and Sasha in it, because Nia had a great showing at WrestleMania and is going to be a huge star for WWE for years to come when everything finally clicks and she gets on that level, and she's getting there quickly. But she's not there yet. I mean, she's still greener than grass shit, or grass shit? Is that a thing? Anyway. But she, you know, she's not there yet. I personally wanted to see Emma and Dana Brooke in this four-way, just because those two, they're not being used. And Emma, I really wanted Emma to come back and just right off the bat get a shot at the title. To do a number one contender style match, win, get a shot at the title. But, you know, they made Alexa the number one contender. Hometown, she got a great pop when she come out because it's her hometown. And she, or I don't know if it's her hometown, but it's her home state anyway. So she got a big pop, just like Dean did earlier. And, it, you know, she no-sold it. She's a heel. She should have. And it was great. I mean, this isn't Canada. If this was Canada or in another country, then I would understand it if she come out and hyped them up. But she didn't do that. There may have been a little bit of that right at the very end of her entrance when she's in the ring and right before they cut to Mickey's music, but it's okay. She didn't really hype. I mean, they cheered and she just kind of blew it off, like, whatever. God, I don't need you cheering for me. I don't care. Which was perfect. And then she won. She no-sold the pop that she got, which was fantastic again. And now we get Alexa versus Bayley in 2 weeks of payback, which is, I think, is going to be a good match. I can't wait to see it. Finn Balor versus Curt Hawkins. I mean, it kind of is what it is. It was quick, and it was done quick for a reason, because Finn just had a concussion, and I'm actually really surprised that he was even wrestling on the show. But, you know, they wanted to give him something, and to give him something quick like that, I'm fine with, and I'm sure he passed the protocol. The Jericho promo, it's over with me. Jericho is just the absolute king of one-liners. And then the Drifter walking by, playing his guitar. Again, perfect use of the Drifter. Cesaro and Jeff Hardy. To me, I've had tons of shit going on all day. So it's been hard for me to focus on one thing or another. I mean, one thing for longer than like 2 minutes. So I didn't give it the attention that it deserves. I'll go back. I'm going to watch it later. But it was kind. It is kind of a big match, and you know, for them two to actually have a one-on-one match is pretty cool. Leading into the pay-per-view, I can't wait to see Cesaro and Sheamus versus the Hardys. Now, that's all I got. Make sure to come back tomorrow night for the SmackDown 401. As always, I'm out. Deuces, Chaos. is out.